New Testament lesson in John's Gospel. Chapter 15, very familiar word there in John's Gospel. Chapter 15 talks about the vine. Mm-hmm. The union between God's church and his people, and this parable of the vine lets us know that, amen, if we are connected to the Lord,
yeah.
Amen. Some way, somehow, whatever you need,
amen.
He will provide.
Yes, amen.
I might be the only one up in here to know that the Lord will provide.
Amen.
Being, Sister Erica, being a type A personality, you know, I try to figure stuff out on paper. At least my wife tell me that when we prepare to go on a trip, I at least have it in my head. Daddy Cameron, she criticizes me and she cuts me, and she said, now, everybody else in the house, they pack is in a suitcase. But what I normally do, Sister Paula, I wait till about 10 minutes before it's time to go. And because, see, up until then, it's in my head.
Amen.
I know which socks and which shoes, which shirt, whether a suit or jeans, whatever, you know, be a tie, I have it in my head. But y'all, sometimes you do have to, amen.
Amen.
Because what I'm finding, the older I get, the more I do that, I forget something, amen.
Amen.
And then y'all, what I have to do, I have to say, honey, did you remember to pack, amen. I thank you, God, for a good wife, because where I come up short, I talk about all the bags she have, but she have it in there. Yes, she does. Amen. So I'm just bless God. And you know, that's a wonderful thing about marriage, because when the Lord puts you together, you know where you show, amen, they strong. And the Lord just works it out that way. So I'm just glad about it. Amen. And y'all, we find out in this verse, in this passage of scripture, to know that if you are just tied into the Lord, that whatever you need, when you need it, how you need it, the Lord will provide.
Yes, amen.
Someone said the Lord will make a way.
Amen.
If you can't get with the Lord providing, some of you know the Lord will make a way.
Yes, amen.
Some of you may know that the Lord will answer your prayer. That even when you didn't understand and you didn't know, the Lord answered. And it's because it's a blessing being tied into Jesus.
Amen.
Now, if you don't want to be blessed, if you want to have a life of struggle, if you want to have a life of stuff coming at you and not have a hope for a better tomorrow, then try being not tied into the Lord. Amen. Now, see, I had to preface that because, see, sometimes we try to say that if you're in the Lord, you're not going to have struggles. If you're in the Lord, you're not going to have troubles. But I've come to let you know, yes, stuff will come. Amen. Stuff will happen. But the difference is you respond a little differently because you got a little Jesus operating on the inside of you. So in John chapter 15 and verse 11, which is our text for this sermon. John's Gospel 15, verse 11. These things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Is it anybody shouting on the inside, not telling God thank you? The Lord said that if you just stay tied into me, I want to let you know two things. Number one is you're going to have joy.
Amen.
Unspeakable joy. And then secondly, he promises us to let us know that not only are you just going to have it, but it's going to be full.
Yeah.
It's going to be running over. That even when you got situations in your life that are cause you to cry, all of a sudden you're going to get the anointing of new joy in your life.
Amen.
And so the sermon title this morning is The Fruit of New Joy.
Amen.
We need to know this because not a week goes by that something does not happen to us. Amen?
Amen.
Now y'all need to know that the longer you live, the more you live, the more stuff will happen.
Amen.
But the wonderful thing is by being in Jesus, tied into Jesus, you can still have the joy of the Lord.
Amen.
You can still be excited when things happen because you know just as the Lord brought you to it, he will bring you through it. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Amen.
My new joy
is tied into Jesus.
Can I get the benediction now?
Yes.
Because see, what it is, we want to tie joy into other stuff.
Watch out. Amen.
Could I call the roll?
Amen.
Joy might be tied into a man.
Amen.
Joy might be tied into a woman.
Amen.
Joy might be tied into somebody that ain't figured out.
All right.
Oh yeah, you'll get it when you look at YouTube. Amen.
Amen.
What? And your joy might be tied into something of the world, and y'all can just kind of fill in the blank. But I come to let you know that real joy and new joy is tied into Jesus.
That's right.
And I'm so glad about it because see, it doesn't matter where you live. It doesn't matter where you work. It doesn't matter what you do in life and in ministry. Jesus is always there. So my brothers and sisters, even as you look at me as the under shepherd of this church, and you say, well, we're looking at Reggie. He ain't much to look at. But see, it's not on the outside where God is looking. He's looking at the ministry of his anointing operating on the inside of me. That even when I can't control myself, the Holy Ghost can do whatever I need. And I read the passage in Proverbs in the reading of our scripture this morning, talking about if you need wisdom, just call on the Lord and he'll guide you. He'll direct you. It's something about the wisdom of the Lord. He'll lead you if you just allow him to lead you.
Amen.
Well, not only is this new joy tied into Jesus, secondly, our testimony to the world is to have new joy in the Lord, to rejoice in the Lord, to stay excited in the Lord. You ever met anybody that every time you see them, they're excited, they're smiling, they're joyful? It's because they're tied into things of Jesus.
Amen.
And so this is the testimony that we are to give the world.
Amen.
That God is still good.
Yes,
he's still on the throne.
Yes.
He's still handing out blessings.
Amen.
He's still making ways out of no ways.
Yes.
He's still delivering.
Yes.
He's still healing. He's still doing just what we need him to be. That even in the midnight hour you're crying, Jesus is there. Even when you have a sleepless night and you can't go to sleep, Jesus is right there.
Yes.
Do I have anybody that's dealing with bronchitis and sinus issues and respiratory concerns, even when you're just trying to have breath, Jesus is right there.
Yeah.
So have you told him thank you?
Yeah.
See, you heard Brother Greg praying, and he said, we just need to tell God thank you for every breath.
Yeah.
Thank you for waking up this morning.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So we got to let the world know that our testimony is that God has not left us, but he's alive. And then they're going to ask you, how do you know he's alive? Well, every now and then I can feel him. How do you know you're feeling Jesus? Well, in my hands hands, I feel them. Because in my feet, I feel them. And it's because even when I think about the goodness of the Lord, stuff just starts moving.
Yeah.
Because see, I can think about this world and it doesn't have any effect on me. I can think about the job that I have. It doesn't have any effect on me. But when I think about how good God is, oh yeah, this hand may go up. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
This foot may move because I realize that God has been so good.
Yeah.
But thirdly, my brothers and sisters, the reason we have to shout and to shout in a loud voice, because I was reading verse 11 to you, and in verse 11 alone is the promises he's given unto us. Promise number one is that my joy will remain in you as long as you remain in me.
Amen. Amen.
Promise number two is that my joy will always be full.
Yeah.
I looked up that word full in the Hebrew and in the Greek, and it says an overflowing, everlasting, never ending.
Amen.
That's wonderful, y'all.
Amen.
To know that the promises of God let us know that not only will his joy remain in us, but it will remain ever ending and never stopping.
Amen.
So even though, hallelujah, even though troubles come,
amen,
the songwriter, Pastor Timothy Wright, bless him, Lord, he's going on to be with the Lord. But he said, trouble don't last always.
Yeah.
And then in the psalm said, we've been made and do for nothing, but joy comes in the morning. So,
yeah,
so we know, because we've been promised here in the book of John that his joy will remain in you.
Amen.
And that his joy will be ever ending. So that's consolation. That's a word for somebody to know that you can keep smiling. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can keep looking to the hill,
yes,
from which cometh all your help. You can keep on saying hallelujah anyhow.
Yes.
Keep telling the Lord thank you, because your joy is going to be ever ending. Tell the Lord thank you for ever ending joy. Even if you get a pink slip from a job, they say your job has terminated, but because you belong to the Lord, you know that door closed, that another one has opened up. If nobody else gonna say amen, I know Sister Erica's gonna say amen. One job closed out, but look at some other stuff just open up. See, we thought Christian was gonna do big stuff here in Newberry County, but now I have to make appointments with her over in Lexington. Oh, bless the name of our God. So don't be so upset when something shut down on this side. You get mad, regusted, mad at the world, because the Lord had to move you out of that situation to show you I got something even better for you. God will set you up. I know it seems like it's a delay. It seems like you're going through, but it's not a deny. Just hold on. Let your joy hang on in there. Let your joy remain full. Your blessing is around the corner. And I dare you to praise God anyhow, because just when you need, the Lord will provide. See, the new joy is tied into Jesus,
yes,
the Christ.
Yes.
And as saints of God, we got to give a testimony to the world,
yes,
that our God still lives.
Amen.
And finally, knowing that in verse 11, the promises have been given unto us. Promise number one is that his joy will remain in us. And number two is never end.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Amen.
God, we thank you that our joy has been made full.
Amen.
We've come as your servants and as your disciples from many different walks of life, God, to just say to you, thank you.
Thank you.
For you reminding us of new joy in you.
Yes.
God, we thank you for the word that
yes,
Pastor John gave the church, and God, that we're able to just kind of overhear his sermon.
Yes.
To come now to 2016 and say, Lord, we thank you.
Amen.
For restoration, God. Thank you for blessings. Thank you for the assurance.
Yes.
That you will take us through. God, we give your name praise. It's in Jesus, the Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.